Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is narrator, Chief Engineer Ravi Gupta. Today we are going to talk about gate valve. In today's video, we will see what is a gate valve, what are the application of the gate valve, what are the characteristics of the gate valve. After that, we will see what are the type of gate valve, and then through animation, we will see how the gate valve works. So please tune till last. I guarantee after watching the today video, you will have a clear knowledge of a gate valve, each and everything. So let's start today's video of a gate valve. If you want to see a similar video about the glow valve, so please check the description link. You will find the glow valve, quick closing valve and pressure reducing valve link. So let's start today's video of a gate valve. So as I have told you here, what are the part of a gate valve? So this is the bonnet, this is the valve body, this is the stem, this is the gland backing stuffing box area, this is the hand wheel, and this is the valve, and this is the valve seat or retaining ring. So these are the component important in the gate valve. Now we need to see this thing. First, if you want to do the overhauling of this gate valve, how will you do? So first thing, you close the valve. After that, remove this bonnet, okay, and then you can separate out this bonnet and this part. After removing these two parts, now when you are taking out this bonnet, before that I have told you to close the valve. When you have closed the valve, the along with the stem, the valve will come out, and after that, rotating it anti-clockwise, you can separate the stem and the valve. So this is how you can do the overhauling of a gate valve. It's a very simple overhauling. Just you have to check the retaining ring, you have to check the valve seat, you have to check the valve, you have to check the condition of threads, and after that you can box back. Okay, now you should know what are the application of the gate valve. So basically, gate valve is a type of valve in which act right angle to the flow. It means if the flow is in this direction, the valve is basically acting on a right angle. So it is placed at a right angle to the flow. So as you can see, if this is the flow, the valve is placed in the right angle side. So normally gate valve are arranged on a right angle to the flow, and after that it is normally taper in the down, or it can be parallel depending upon the design, but most of the time you can see, you will find this taper design. Okay, so these are the features of the gate valve. So by outside look, you can differentiate it is a gate valve. How? If the valve size is long, if it is looking taper in section, and if it is placed right angle to the flow, then it is a gate valve. Okay, now basically the gate valve is suitable for which operation? It is suitable for operation normally to be kept in an open condition. It means gate valve is used only to open or close the fluid flow. It is not used to throttle the fluid flow. Please hear carefully. It means that if any operation which required throttling of the valve, in that side you will find maximum application of the glow valve. Therefore you can see most of the pump valve, centrifugal pump valve, are glow type. So basically what is I mean to say, so it is only used for opening and closing the liquid flow. Now the bonnet are made of mainly cast iron, and therefore it should be very careful. We should be very careful while doing the overhauling. Okay, and now let's see. Now this is the internal diagram. So as you can see, the flow will be coming from here. Okay, and this is the gate. This is parallel type. Okay, this is the parallel type. This is not wedge type. So as you can see, it is going, the flow will be going from here, and this is the gate which is restricting the flow. Now if we open it, if we go open it, so the gate, this gate which is right now here, this part will move here and it will allow the water to flow. So basically, if anybody asks what are the application of the gate valve, you should say the gate valve mainly application is to open and close the flow, not used for flow regulation. So it is, it means, and now why it is used. Now if anybody asks, okay, you are saying it has been used for opening and closing the flow, so why it is used? It has been used because the glow valve characteristic is such that it allow low flow resistance. So if the valve is fully open, so full diameter is exposed to the flow when the gate is moving up. Now you can see this is a diagram where the gate is fully closing the flow. Now when the gate have moved up, there is no resistance in the line and hence the flow is very smooth. So therefore gate valve is used where we require low flow resistance. It means what? It means that if the valve is open slowly and slowly, there will be a non-linear flow, okay, and it will cause too much unstreamlined flow. Now let's see what are the types of the gate valve. So gate valve can be classified based on construction. It can be divided as by which, means by which, if you see, means by which, if you see, it can be, we can say parallel gate valve or wedge gate valve. If by looking at the seat, if we describe, it can be tell metal seat or resilient seat. By stem, if we see classify, we can say with rising or non-rising. So gate valve can be classified based on construction three types. First is by wedge, by seat and by stem. By wedge, parallel, it means what? If now this you are seeing, this is the wedge type, okay. If it is like this, if it is like this, it is parallel. If it is like this, if it is like this, it is wedge. By seat, if the seat is of metal or it is a resilient seat type. By stem, whether the stem is rising or going inside, we will see. Now in last point we have said by stem, what do you mean with rising and not non-rising? So let's see here. So this is a construction of two type of gate valve classified based on stem. So here in the design you can see there is a thread inside the gate, there is a thread inside the gate and the valve is in closed condition. Now we are opening the valve, so this thread which is right now here, this thread which is now right now here, while moving up, this will move inside this thing. I will repeat one more time. You see carefully here, there is a thread made inside the gate valve and now the valve is in closed condition. When we are opening the valve, this thread which is here is moving inside the thread which is made inside the gate valve and it is moving up, so opening the valve. Now if the thread is not made inside the gate valve, then what will happen? Then the stem will have to move up and there will be a thread made here. The thread will be made here, so it will look like this. Now when the valve is closed, now when we are opening it up, the thread is, the stem is moving up. So this is called rising type and this is called non-rising type. You will have a clear concept here when you will see. Now depending on the end of the stem, we can classify whether it is rising or non-rising. If the stem is rising after opening, it means that the thread is made here, not inside the gate, and therefore after opening the thread is moving, the stem is moving out. So this is called rising stem type. There will be a visual indication clearly by the moving out of the stem that valve is open. And if the thread is made inside the valve, it is called non-rising, and it need to have a indication here in the stem here, open or shut, open or shut. Okay, so this is how we can classify what are the types of gate valve. Now so you can see this is the rising type valve. The flow is been closed here. Now when we are opening it, you can see the stem is moving up. So this is how the gate valve will look like. So if anybody asks you how you will classify the gate valve, you can say only three things. It will be placed right angle to the flow, it will be taper or wedge in section, and it will be elongation long valve. Okay, so friend, if you have learned something in today's video, please do like, please do subscribe, and please do share. And if you want to ask any question, please do comment below. I will reply well. Thank you, friend. Have a